Hello everyone and welcome to part 2 of this game versus Oomph. I'm just now getting rid of that Jackal in the reactor so I can just get it and get Goss and hopefully try and get Canister Shell as well, because in the end what's going to actually kill the Arbiter is going to be Canister Shell. But he actually did take my reactor up there, so I realized I'll probably just end up having to get a third reactor. And because I saw that he took that reactor, I knew his Arbiter was away from his base, so I was going to try and make him recall, but he did put a shield up so there's no point. And so now I do have Tech 2 again, and I am going to try and get another reactor up because I'm going to need one. I'm kind of iffy on when I should actually be attacking, and I don't have Canister Shell yet. All I have is a bunch of Grenadier Hogs and some tanks that don't even have Canister Shell. But I do see that he has his hooks and I have my hooks, so it's pretty much an even game at this point. I do still have my cryo bomb, so I gotta keep that in mind in case he does some sort of switch to air or something, but I doubt he would because I do have a lot of hogs. And right now I do see that he actually has his army teleported with his Arbiter, meaning he's not at his base, and because of how weak Covenant bases are, I realize that I should really attack right now while his army is not at his base, because that means all I'll have to defend is turrets. And I don't think he has that many turrets at all, so I'm just going to try and attack him and take advantage of the fact that his army is with him. So now I am finally getting that other reactor. I'm going to be using it to get Goss and Canister because I'm going to need both. I was debating about whether to wait for those, but I realize it's only a matter of time before he just goes back to either his base or he's just going to attack me and I might end up having to defend. And I see that he does have a Terra on the same side as this one, so all I have to do is kill that one and go over to the other side of his base and start attacking. Now he does have the shield up, but he also still has two hulls because he does control both the money hooks, so that's actually a good call by him. And now I'm just going to kill all the hunters that come through to his base, and he's just going to end up locking it because he needs to now. And now that reactor is finally finishing, and I'm hoping that I'm going to be able to get Goss and Canister before his army is able to walk over here. He could just recall his Arbiter right now, but it would he would pretty much die instantly, so there's no real point to that. So he has to wait till his army walks over here, because I attacked him before while he had his whole army with his Arbiter, and that's what you want to try and do, is get their army out of position as the UNSC on this map because of your building damage. So now he is unlocking his base, and I thought that's not really that big a deal, and then all of a sudden he actually sandwiches me with his hunters here, and so I'm just going to completely ram these hunters. They do have Spirit Bond, but I'm going to ram them because when they get rammed they don't attack anymore and they take a lot of damage from that. And I'm just going to be using my hogs as meat shields, and I want to try and keep these tanks alive because once they get Canister Shell they can take on hunters and the Arbiter, and in the end that's what I want, is Canister tanks if I'm facing hunters and Arbiters. And so you just gotta really utilize RAM when you're facing this many hunters like this. And I finally do have that Goss upgrade, and I'm gonna be getting a Canister Shell here pretty soon, so that should really help. He is pumping out a lot of hunters though. He does have both those supply elevators, so he's able to do that. But like I said, if you just use RAM right, then it'll turn in your favor. Now that I finally do have Canister Shell, I can just Canister Shell these hunters, so my tanks can take on one hunter, and my hogs can take on another by ramming. They are all really low health, but it was definitely worth it. I was able to clean up all those hunters really easily. And now that he doesn't have an Arbiter, because I did manage to ram him, he's going to have to try and rely on double producing these hunters. My D-bomb's also almost back, so that's always good. And I do realize that he has a locked base, so what I'm going to do is heal right outside his base where he can see, and hope that I can make him unlock his base so that he doesn't have as many hunters when he unlocks when he normally would. So now he doesn't have a temple to get his Arbiter back, and the only economy he really has is two unupgraded warehouses and those supply elevators. And so now I did try and save that tank, but I wasn't able to, and you really gotta be careful when you're ramming hunters that are all bunched up like that. That actually sometimes won't work out in your favor at all. And tanks also don't move when using Canister Shell, something you want to try and take note of, and that you really want to be careful when you decide you're going to ram something or Canister Shell something. But it does look like he's not going to be able to produce enough hunters to stop me from killing his base. All units. And so now he finally blows up his base, and I mainly put up this video because it's Enders vs. Arbiter, and it's a really fun matchup, I think, and I hope you enjoyed this game and the commentary. Oomph actually is mainly a teams player, but he's trying to get better at 1v1, so again, I hope you enjoyed this game.